Hello and greetings from Iceland. In this update, I will be focusing at the eruption that we kind of forgot all about while this magma dike was forming under the village Grindavík and almost ruined the town after the land subsided November 10th. And today we just got it confirmed that magma is still flowing into the storage near the Blue Lagoon where all this mess started. And that is at 4.5 kilometers depth. And the magma inflow now is 8 to 10 times more than before the November 10th event. Back then, the inflow was between 5 and 7 cubic meters per second. But now it is around 50 cubic meters per second. So here we go again. This means that the land around here, Svartsengi, where the power plant and the Blue Lagoon are located, it has started to lift again. But it dropped 40 centimeters after the magma took off to form the dike and this land is recovering faster now. One of our volcanologists came up with three scenarios. Number one, we might get an eruption even today and it could take place where the land uplift epicenter is or near the Blue Lagoon. But number two, the magma might take off again to the dike, widen it even further and damage the ground under Grindavík even more. And then lead to an eruption, or not. And number three, we might get something completely different. And it was not stated what it would be. And the dike that formed under the town is actually categorized as something quite different. And what attracts the most attention is how fast this happened. But I'm not going to dive into the details now. I'm only going to say that experts around the world have a big task. Working through all the data that is still to be gathered because this is so not over. This is a disaster movie in slow motion. And what still worries us the most is the location. The eruption that we have been expecting seems to get only bigger, but where? And I do actually have a little bit of better news now. The chances of an eruption occurring above the magma dike is decreasing. In fact, one of our professors, Ármann Höskuldsson was always of that opinion, while most of the other scientists were expecting the eruption to come up in the so-called Sundanhjúkar crater row or almost directly above the magma dike. And that is where barriers have been constructed, and they will of course be useless if we are looking into a new scenario now. So this 200 meter long row of craters near the Blue Lagoon is again the center of attention. I did actually scan this area with a thermal drone almost daily before this disaster in town and access to it was closed. So I simply can't get there now and I wish I could because I would like to see if I could detect any changes and I will continue to try. But most importantly now, what we are looking at if the eruption takes place there is actually a scenario that I have been looking at before. It's just a matter of few hundred meters where the fire comes up. Whether this will be a disaster or a major disaster. So the best thing to come out of this now would be to see the eruption come up by those 13th century craters, Eldvörp. Since from there, it's the best chance we have that the lava will just float to the ocean. But if it is going to be a fairly big eruption near the Blue Lagoon, where the land uplift epicenter has been for the longest time, in such case there would be very little time to make any lava barriers. The Blue Lagoon would be first to go, then the power station, but the town might be safe, because the mountain Thorbjörn and its surroundings is a good natural protection. However, without a power plant to heat the houses in town, that are heated with hot water, it would be very hard to get things going there again. And already I'm hearing 6 to 8 months until people can move back because the hot water grid and the energy grid is a total mess. So if we would lose the power station, things don't look good. And especially since this is not a one single event taking place now, we are moving into a long chapter of unrest that might easily change the way we live here in Iceland forever, especially on the Reykjanes Peninsula. and it is the uncertainty that is worst. Like we got those numbers today, huge quantity of magma flowing in, and when the tank is about to be full, like before the November 10th event, the earthquakes will start again, or until something gives in. So we don't know what to expect this time. We only expect more earthquakes in a few hours or days. And the only thing we know for sure is that this situation is here to stay for a long time. Or something like this every few months or years. Or a new reality that all Icelanders will have to face and accept. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.